has been a humbling experience, to say the least. And we've spent our time, we actually just came back from watching the Changing of the Guard, which is another experience that you have to have if you have an opportunity to come to Washington. But I wanted to share the story of the National Cemetery, where it began. And so Patrick is the best person to tell that story, so that you guys would find it interesting as to how the cemetery began.
Well, the way the Arlington National Cemetery actually started was top of the hill. I mean, this is a large amount of land, hundreds of acres here, where our men and women in military and in uniform have been buried. But what was interesting about it was before it actually became a cemetery, this is where Robert E. Lee's home was.
Yeah,
Robert E. Lee, he was the Confederate general, and he was at the time regarded as one of the most revered generals in the U.S. military. And where he lived was at the top, which is now called the Arlington House. But he wanted to live in the country and loved Virginia. This was his homeland and was close to the city. You could see it from the top of his hill, and it was an amazing view from there. So what happened was, when the Civil War began, the Union forces, the Union side, obviously separated from the Blues and the Grays, the Union requested that Robert E. Lee, being such a revered Army general, lead the Union Army in the fight during the Civil War. But Robert E. Lee felt very conflicted about that, and his choice was to stick with his mother Commonwealth and fight for the South and fight for Virginia. And this was taken as sort of a shot to the Union side. They were really insulted by the fact that they felt that he betrayed the country. And being such a powerful general, they felt that they were going to be at a disadvantage early on. What ended up happening, obviously, is during that, which we know is the most bloodiest war in American history, many Union soldiers died, and on the Union side, they felt that Robert E. Lee should see what blood was the blood stained on his hands from choosing to be on the Confederate side. Obviously, the Confederate side ending up not
the result of his choice.
Yeah, the result of his choice. They started burying Union soldiers in his yard, so it was set to be as a reminder to him that because of the decision you made, you're now going to have this blood on your hands, and when you come back and forth to and from your home, you're going to be walking on the dead bodies of the soldiers that you were responsible for. And this turned into what now is today is the National Cemetery, where all military forces, all the men and women in our armed forces, have the option to be buried here. So.
And you can imagine Lee, you know, every time he comes home, walks outside his front door, he just sees nothing but gravestones. Obviously, the cemetery has grown since then. You're only looking at a small portion of what we've seen today. There are, I believe, 600 some odd acres of land that have actually been appropriated for the burial of soldiers. And I just thought that was a really compelling story that Patrick had told me about Robert Lee, that the consequence of his decision to fight on the Confederate side, leading to the deaths of fellow brothers within the Union itself. And I just thought that was an incredible story, just imagining, you know, Lee after the war having to come home and look outside his front window, and all you see is, you know, the graves of soldiers that he helped to put into the ground. So just want to take a moment to kind of recognize the history of the cemetery. Thank you very much, Patrick.
Yeah. Oh, one other thing, actually, was originally it was just the Union soldiers that were brought here. Mm. It was later on in history, or later on, after much later after the Civil War, where the Confederate soldiers were then brought back here and buried here as part of the U.S. again.
And so the cemetery began to expand from that point.
Yeah.
So if you have an opportunity to come out here, you really have to. You could spend hours out here. It really is a very sobering and humble experience. Again, the changing of the guards, if there's anything that makes you proud to be an American, it's watching that process. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll do a quick little shot. Yeah, Patrick and I will get out of the way so you don't have to look at our ugly mugs. But you have an opportunity to kind of appreciate what we've just been talking about. So.
part of. Ready? Hey. Then, hey, pass on your order.
Hope and order remain as directed.
Order, act on.
Ready, hey.
This is Kennedy's grave, the eternal flame. For longtime fans of the show, you guys should be familiar with these words if you guys remember the RFK speech that I had played on Stimulated Boredom a long time ago when Martin Luther King was assassinated. And this is part of the speech from Aeschylus, as he was talking about the assassination of his own brother and talking about understanding the pain of losing somebody that you love.